Finite state machine is a device which stores the state of something, and the state will change, which is based on inputs, providing the resulting output for implemented changes. So, it's a model of computation based made of one or more states, and only one single state of this machine can be active at the same time, which means that the machine has a transition from one state to another to perform the different action. So the main thing we have to keep in mind for finite state machine is we have a fixed set of states that the machine can be in, then a machine can only be in one state at a time, then a sequence of inputs is sent to a machine, and the last is that every state has a set of transition and every transition is associated with an input and pointing to a state. Now the next comes the types of finite state machine. So generally there are three types of finite state machine. First one is finite state automata, second is Mealy machine, and the third one is Moore machine. So finite state automata is with output and it's a machine to recognize patterns, and it have a five tuples. It has a set of states and rules for moving from one state to another, but mainly depends upon the applied input signal. Then the next comes Mealy machine. So the Mealy machine is an FSM whose output depends mainly on a present state as well as present input. As I have told earlier, that Mealy machine is a finite state machine whose values are totally depend upon the current state and current inputs. So Mealy machine is a deterministic finite state transducer. For each state and an input, at most one transition is possible, and these are constant to the Moore machine whose output values are depend by current state. So there are six tuples which can be described here. The first one is Q, which is a finite set of states, and the second one is Sigma, which is a finite set of symbols called input alphabet. The third one is Delta, which is a finite set of symbols called the output alphabet, and the fourth one is lowercase delta, is an input transition function. Then the fifth one is lambda, which is a output transition function, and the last one is a Q naught, which is the initial state from where an input is processed. So this is the state diagram of a Mealy machine, which associates an output value with each transition edge in a contrast to the state diagram. So when the input and output alphabets both are sigma, one can also associate to a Mealy automata. And these are vertices where couples of states and letters and every nodes are of out degree 1, and the successor of X and I is the next state of the automata, and the result that the automata output when it's instant X and it reads the letter I. So here we can see that when the present state is A and we have given the input 0 and the state is B, then output will be X1. Similarly, when the input is given 1 and the state is C, then output will be X1. Then the next comes when the present state is given B and the input is 0, where the state is B, then output will be X2. Similarly, when the input is given 1 and the state is D, then output will be X3. So when the present state is C and input given is 0, then state is D and output will be X3. And when input is given 1, state is C, then output will be X1. And last, the present state is D. When input is given 0, state is D, then output will be X3. And when input is given 1, then state is D and output will be X2.
A Moore machine is the finite state machine in which the output depends only on the present state. Basically, unlike the Mealy machine where the output value used to depend on the input value as well, here in this Moore machine, the output value does not depend on the input values. Just like the Mealy machine, Moore machine can also be described by six tuple Q, then summation delta, now lambda, and Q0, where Q0 finite set of states, and summation is the finite set of symbols representing the input alphabets. Delta represents the output alphabets, DAO is the input transition, and the lambda, which is the output function. Lambda represents the output function. Q0 is the same initial state belonging one of the Q states. So here we can see a state diagram of a Moore machine. Here we can see for whatever input we give to the present state. Basically, if we take example of here the present state A, if we give input 0 or 1, the output always will be x2. So it does not depend on what input we give, the output will remain the same for whatever input we give. Similarly for B, C and D also, whatever input we give, whether we give 0 or 1, the output will remain same. For B, the output will be x1, for C it will be x2, and for D it will be x3. Here we can see with the transition table also the same thing. Whatever input we give, whether it be it 0 or be it 1, the output will be fixed. For A it will be x2, for B it will be x1, and for C and D it will be x2 and x3 respectively, whatever the input be it, or whatever the next state it be it. Now let's take a look at the conversion of a Moore machine to a Mealy machine. Step 1 is to copy Moore machine transition table, Moore machine states into a table format. Here is the diagram of the Moore machine. Basically, we have to create a transition table of this Moore machine that we have created here. For every input A and B, we write the corresponding output and the next states. Like for input A in the present state Q0, we can see the output will be Q1, and for B the next state will be Q1, and for input B the next state will be Q0, but the output will be 0 only for both the cases. As we can see here, the output remains 0 whatever we give the input, whether A or B. Same is for Q1 and Q2 also, whatever we give as the input, the output remains fixed. So to convert this into Mealy machine, the next step is to check the present states and their corresponding outputs in the Moore machine state table. And for a state QI output in M in the Moore machine, we have to copy the output columns. We have to copy into the output columns of the Mealy machine state table wherever QI state appears. Basically, what it means here for this present state Q0 and input A, we can see here that the next state becomes Q0, and the next state becomes for input and the next state becomes Q1 and output becomes 0. So here also for the next state, for input A the next state becomes Q1, but the output remains 0. Similarly for input B, the next state becomes Q0, but output remains 0. For present state Q1 with input A, the next state becomes Q1 and the output remains 0. For input B, the next state is Q2 and the output is 1. Now, why the output is 1? It's because the output for this Moore machine, for Moore machine, the output with present state Q2 is 1. So that is why in the corresponding next state, which is Q2 here, we'll put the output as 1. Same for Q2 as well. With input A, the output becomes Q1. And since the output in the Moore machine for Q1 is 0, we will put here the output as 0. For input B, the next state becomes Q0, which again in the corresponding Moore machine is 0. The output is 0 for Q0. So we will put here the output as 0. Here is the equivalent Mealy machine that we have made just now by converting it from the Moore machine. For input A, output remains 0. For input B, the output remains 0. Basically, this transition table is what we have drawn here.
So, as we can see, the transition of Mealy machine to Moore machine. So the first step is to copy all the Mealy machine transition states into the table format. So we can see the table. present state, then we give the input and both the inputs in the next state. Here is the Mealy machine diagram. The second step is to copy the state, initial state QI, if all the outputs of QI are the same. Then we break QI into n states as QIN if it has n distinct outputs, where n is equal to 0, 1, 2, so on. The state Q1 has only one output, so we don't need to break. The state Q2 and Q3 have both outputs as 0 and 1, so we will create two states for the three states. For Q2, two states will be Q2O with output 0 and Q2-1 with output 1. Similarly, for Q3, two states will be Q3-0 and Q3-1. Here we can see the transition table from Moon machine. Here we can see the transition machine for the Moon machine. Here, as the present state is Q1 and we give the input as 0, the next state becomes Q1, and when we give the input 1, the next state is Q2-0. Similarly, the other present states and next states, you can see here is the equivalent Moon machine diagram. We can, in Mealy machine, output depends both upon the present state and the present input, but in Moore machine, output depends only upon the present state. Mealy machine generally has fewer states than Moore machine, and Moore machine has more states. Mealy machine is a bit difficult to design, output is placed on transitions. Moore machine is easy to decide, design output is placed on states. In Mealy machines, it reacts faster to inputs. They generally react in the same clock cycle. In Moore machine, more logic is required to decode the circuits, resulting in more circuit delays. Lastly, we see some uses of Mealy and Moore machine. Mealy state machines are usually in processors due to their property of having more states. Mealy state machines are also used in to provide a rudimentary mathematical model for cipher machines. A Moore state machine is used as a write enable in secondary RAM because of its speed. It is used in SRAM because SRAM needs a level sensitive control.
Okay, very good presentation.